Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we created our very first Jetpack Compose project. And in this video, we will move a little ahead and we will learn more about the text function, that is a composable function. And we use this function to create a text in our UI. And this function is going to be used very frequently because it is the equivalent to text view. And you can imagine how frequently we use a text view in designing our Android UIs. So let's come back to the project. It is the same project that we created in the last video, and I have deleted everything, and that is why we are not seeing the preview here, because I have also deleted the preview function. So in this project, first I will create a composable function. And you know, to create a composable function, we need to use the @composable annotation. So here I will write, outside the activity, I will write @composable, and I will create a function named, let's say, title. Now this function will display a text in our UI. So what I will do is I will use text. Now text is another composable function and it displays a text. So I will pass, let's say, simplified code name like this. So now this will display a text in our UI. If you go to the definition of this text function, then you can see we have a bunch of parameters for this text function. So we can pass a text, we can pass a modifier. We already learned about modifier in the last video. So if you want, you can pass a modifier as well to your text function. But for now, we will pass something else. So let's again go to the definition, and here we can pass color, we can pass font size, we can pass font style, we can pass font family, and you can pass a lot of things that you do with XML. But as we are using Jetpack Compose, we have these things to customize our text in the UI. So if you want to change the font size, what you can do is you can pass font size. So here you can pass font size, and let's say I want to make it 32. So I can write 32.sp like this. Now sp here is an extension of int. And if you go to the definition, then you can see it is returning us the text unit. So this is how you can use sp or dp as you were using in your XML designing method. So we have a text, simplified coding, and the font size is 32sp. You can also pass color. So if you want to pass color, you can pass color. I will make every parameter in an individual line so that it is properly visible. So for color, you can pass a color like this. Or if you want to use a color from a resource, then what you can do is you can use color resource function. And here you can pass r.color. Let's say purple 700. So whatever colors are defined in your resource file, you can use it like this. So now we have a text of size 32 and of this purple color. If you want to preview this thing, then you need to create a preview function. So here I will write preview. You need to use this annotation if you want to preview your composable function. And here I will pass show background to true because I want to see the background. And then I will create a function. It is again a composable function. And I will name it, let's say, default preview. And inside this function, we will call the function that we want to preview. In this case, I want this title. So I will write title like this. So here you can see we are getting the preview of our text. So this was our text. We have assigned a size 32 and we assigned a color that is purple. So that is why we are getting a text like this. Now again, it is very small. So last time we created a surface, and inside the surface we created the text. But in this case, I do not want my title to be wrapped inside a surface. So what I will do is I will write the surface here just for preview purpose. So I will write surface, and I will put this title inside the surface, and I will pass a modifier fill max size like this. And we need to remove these things and we need to import the modifier. Now if I preview it again, I will see the full Android screen, and at the top we have our simplified coding text. If you want to change the font, you can do that as well. So here we will pass font family. And for the font family, we can pass font family, let's say cursive. So now you can see the font is changed. So this is how you can play with text and you can assign your custom design to the text function. Now, if you want to make this text clickable, then in that case, you need to pass a modifier to the text. So again, here I will write modifier equals to modifier. And there is a clickable modifier that you can use if you want to make your text or composable functions clickable. So we have this clickable here and we will get a callback whenever we will tap this text because we have passed this clickable modifier. And for now, I will just display a toast when this text is clicked. I hope you know how we display a toast because it is a very simple thing. The method is same. We just use the toast class. So we will write toast.makeText. For the first parameter, we need to pass context. I will tell you how we will get the context. And for the next parameter, we will pass, let's say, title clicked. And for the last parameter, we will pass toast.lengthLong. And then finally, we will call the show function. Now we need the context to make this work. So here I will create a context and I will use local context dot current. So we have the context. This is how we will get the context inside a composable function and we will use the context wherever it is required. In this case, we are using the context to display a toast. Now let's try running the application to see whether it is working or not. But before, we need to set our composable function to the content of the activity. And to do this, we use the setContent function. So I will call this function and I will pass title like this. Now let's run the application. You can see we are getting our output. If I click on the simplified coding, then I'm getting the toast. So in this video, we learned how we can use a text, how we can customize the text, and how we can attach a click listener to the text. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any problem or question, you can leave it in the comments below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.